No matter who you are, no matter what you do, who among us has not at some point in their lives considered a career as a rock star? And who has not looked on in awe at an amazing drum solo? Well, today, my friends, I live the dream. I get a lesson in the art of the drum solo from one of the world's greatest drummers. He's with me now from Rush, Neil Peart. Neil, how are you?
Hi, how are you?
Good to see you. So, Neil, when you're not drumming with the drums, you're on a motorcycle.
I travel between drums, between drum solos, you might say, by motorcycle.
Okay, so today I learn how to be you. How do we start?
Well, we're going to start by taking a ride. Put your helmet on.
I have a helmet. Okay. Okay, the ride is over. We've now arrived at an undisclosed location on the outskirts of Toronto. We're basically at the Rush Bat Cave, aren't we?
Yeah.
The archives.
The archives, where the drums live. Neil, let's talk about you as a guy who rides a motorcycle. You're not just a regular guy with a motorcycle.
No, I started about 10 years ago, I guess. When we toured, I used to carry a bicycle all the time, just in the loading bay, and I'd get the driver to stop 100 miles out of town, or if it was day off between shows, I could ride 100 miles between cities. So I started doing that, and it got me interested in seeing more of America and Canada and places we were touring. About 10 years ago, I started touring by motorcycle. Basically, I have a bus with a trailer. I sleep on the bus in a truck stop or something, get up in the morning, unload the bike, and ride all day if there's a show that night to get there, or if it's a day off, just keep going.
How many miles have you put on your motorcycle?
Oh, 200,000, I think, in 10 years.
Really? 200,000?
Yeah.
Can we go in the back cave?
Let's go.
Okay, and I'm going to get a drum lesson?
I'm going to teach you everything you need to know.
This is going to be awesome. Okay, let's go. Okay, this is kind of cool. You park your motorcycle in the Rush Batcave. And there is the drum kit.
A lot of craftsmanship.
And is this gold?
This is real gold plating here, yes.
Real gold?
Yeah.
Because you don't strike me as a bling guy.
No, but the drums can be bling.
This is your bling?
Yeah.
Okay, so can you show me how to do something?
Oh, easily.
Okay, and this is my little drum kit? I'm feeling slightly inadequate. But it's not what you got, it's how you use it, kids. Although, I don't really know how to use it.
I'm gonna show you.
Small is beautiful. Okay, you're gonna show me something?
Yeah.
Can
count,
I do?
Count me in.
All my life I've waited for that. You ready for this?
I'm ready.
I'm supposed to do that.
Okay. Start, to start.
To start, okay, a lesson. What, snare drum?
Yeah, good.
Hi-hat?
Right.
What do I do?
Solo.
Oh.
Solo.
Like that?
Beautiful.
When did you first start playing drums?
When I was 13, actually. My parents
gave you a drum kit?
Drum lessons, no kit? And a pad, no, a little practice pad.
Like one of those little rubber things.
And then I would make drum sets across my bed with magazines and then beat the covers off them. There's five cymbals and eight toms, you know.
You'd have this, that's with the Sears catalog.
A set like this, but made out of magazines.
Why is that boy in that bedroom with the Sears catalog again? What's he doing in there? You're a lyricist.
Mm-hmm.
You've written a lot of the Rush lyrics, I think.
Yeah,
right?
That's right. Yeah.
Now, that's not the stereotypical drummer.
No, in fact, there's a whole raft of excellent drummer jokes based just upon.
Tell me some drummer jokes.
Well, for example, what did the drummer get on his IQ test?
What?
Drool. Good. What do you call a drummer with half a brain?
What?
Gifted. What does a drummer use for birth control?
What?
His personality.
Now getting to the point where we might do something recognizable.
I think you're ready.
Tom Sawyer?
I think you're ready.
Because I have air played Tom Sawyer, like
all Canadian lads have, air-drummed it.
So now we're going to play along to the song and build up to climax with the full rock. Imagine there's 10,000 screaming fans out there screaming for you.
Okay, do I take my shirt off?
And we're going for the big rock finish. You can take your shirt off later.
Okay. All right.
After the show.
We're going to beat these suckers like a rented mule, right? Beat them like an Alberta Liberal. Okay. Neil Peart, thank you very much, sir. Next week, pyro on my news desk. Thanks again.
Well done.
World's greatest drummer.